a while. And it's your girl, Sid Nasty, back at ya. I have not filmed in a hot minute. And I'm just gonna be honest with you, like mentally and emotionally and physically, physically I'm fine. I just haven't been feeling like at 100. So, I haven't really been putting my energy towards this, because I want to give you guys the best of me, you know? Anywho, I was like, okay, it's been like over a week since my last video, so it's time to talk to you guys, right? Okay, hey, I always find it weird when it's been a while, because my brain forgets how to talk, I don't know. So, thought I would just chit-chat with you guys a little bit. And talked. I was like, okay, what can I film about? I wasn't feeling creative. So I was like, well, there's a lot of, like, topics I could talk about. One of them is the new movie Booksmart that just came out. Such a random, I, like, find myself not doing reviews about, like, really popular and things. Like, I know a few people ask me for an Endgame review. I just never put it out there. I don't know. And then people are asking me to do, like, a Game of Thrones, like, what do I think about the season type of video. And I have a lot of thoughts and a lot of things that I, like, told friends and people around me. But I just didn't even sit down to do a video. And I don't know. And then I end up doing, like, really random videos like Booksmart, which I feel like not a lot of people knew about this. At least people that I knew, not a lot of people knew about the movie. Does that make sense? Do I make sense? Also, I tried this organic cold brew coffee. The brand is Allegro. Allegro coffee. Organic cold brew coffee. And it is, the flavor is amber maple. I think they had regular. And this is, ready to drink coffee plus real maple syrup. Very cool. I got it at Whole Foods. I went to Whole Foods this morning. Just before I get into the movie, I don't want to get too much into it, but I've been having some meetings and interviews and blah blah blah. I don't want to talk about that. But I've been very active, like early in the mornings recently. And lost my train of thought. Oh, today I got out of an interview. I was in there for about, it was almost, it was like an hour and a half. I was gonna say almost 2 hours, but it was probably under an hour and a half. It was amazing. It was a really fun time. It was also like a meeting too, whatever. But I got out and it was already 10:30 and I was so bummed because I just missed Chick-fil-A breakfast because their breakfast ends at 10:30. So I was like, ugh. So there's a Whole Foods nearby, and I just like went there because I was like, oh, I'll just get like a donut because I love their vegan donut. And I went in and I got like two. I just got them in a package, and I was like, oh, let me look around the Whole Food. And I don't know why, but I forgot that. I mean, I knew they have hot food, but I looked and I was like, oh my gosh, I could get like food here because they have like hot breakfast food. They had chilaquiles. They have like bacon. They have eggs. They have egg scrambles. They have tater tots. They have potato. They have everything, right? And I was like, dude, I can just literally get food here. So I did that and I got eggs and potatoes and chilaquiles and it was so good. I love Whole Foods so much. And then I ended up getting this coffee there too. Sounds weird, or it's just really spoiling anything. This is like the summary of the movie. So they decide to go to this party, like a graduation party that's happening that night, that last day of school. And basically from that is like the plot. And then a bunch of shenanigans occur. This movie was directed by Olivia Wilde, who is beautiful and amazing and so talented. And I love Olivia Wilde. She's such a great actress. And she directed this film. First off, I will say it. I like when actors go around and direct a movie. I think, I mean, not all actors or not everyone, whatever, but I think there's something about an actor who's been on the in front of the camera and who's had that experience of a really, you know what it's like to be in front of the camera. That is such a great experience to sort of take and then apply it to directing a film. There's something very unique, and I think that a lot of actors really get it, and that's why I think most, at least most, you know, actors who do it well, actors who act well and have a passion for their craft, that's why most of them, I think, do it, or make for great directors, because they know what they're doing, you know? Not all directors, of course, not all actors make great directors, of course, but I think that they have a very specific and special insight that helps them with the direction of the film, if that makes sense. You know what? I also find myself saying, if that makes sense, because for some reason I always think that, like, nobody knows what I'm talking about. But anyways, you guys got it. Okay, cool. So, Olivia Wilde directed. Overall, as far as the, like, directing aspect of the movie, I thought it was very well directed. There's one particular shot in the movie. I mean, there's a lot of great shots, but there's one shot, it's kind of during the climax, that is so well drawn out and sort of, like, figure. It's just, it's a beautiful shot. And if you've seen the movie, you'll kind of know it's during an argument. I will say that, it's during an argument in the movie, and it's really awesome to see that on screen. So that's really fun to see. I like the creativity of some of the shots. Now, the actors, so the two main actors, who are the two girls in the film, are Beanie Feldstein, I think is her name, and Caitlin Dever. She's actually been in a few other things. She was in Lady Bird. She was also in Neighbors 2 with Chloe Grace Moretz. She also happens to be Jonah Hill's sister. And I find that very interesting because this movie has been compared to Superbad, which Jonah Hill starred in. Superbad is one of my favorite movies of all time. It really, really is. I love it with all of my heart. And when I hear the comparison between the two films, I'm not mad about it. I see it. And I'm about it. I will say that. But I won't say don't go in it expecting Superbad. Although, it's a very enjoyable film. But anyways, so that's Beanie Feldstein. And then we also have Caitlin Dever, who I've seen. I know I've seen her in stuff before. She was in A Beautiful Boy with Timothée Chalamet. She had a small part in that movie. I remember her face from there. And she was in something else and I don't remember. But anyways, both of these girls are so great. They're so enjoyable. And one thing that I really like that the movie did is it's a high school setting. I keep doing this. It's a high school setting with, you know, high school seniors and whatnot. So there are a lot of young, fresh faces, and I love it. Oh my gosh. All of the people in this, all the actors in this movie are, like, fairly new. They're like, familiar. Like, I know there's, like, two of the people that are actors that play students, or three, that are, like, I've seen in other things before, but they're not, like, huge stars. And Billy Lord, I will say, Billy Lord is in this movie, and I love her, and she's so amazing. and she's kind of one of the bigger names, I would say. As far as the teenage actors. But they're all so amazing. And I love a fresh face of, like, for casts, you know? They're all so good and so talented and funny. And it's tricky because when you have a cast of, like, kind of, like, people that aren't necessarily big names, those actors have a lot of weight on their shoulders because, you know, like, for example, if you see Jennifer Lopez, I don't know, that was, like, a weird example, but for example, if we see Mila Kunis, who we all love and adore, and she's just in, like, a film and she delivers a few lines, even if the writing, like, kind of sucks, we don't mind as much because it's Mila Kunis, and we love Mila Kunis, and we love who she is, and we're a fan. But if we have an unknown actor delivering those same, like, mediocre lines, it's trickier and harder because we don't love this, we don't know who this person is, and they're just giving us some basic lines that have no weight or aren't, you know, amazing. So, does this make, like, I'm trying to put the point across that when it's an unknown or a relatively new actor, like, they're really relying more on their talent, and I know it sounds like, well, isn't everyone, but no, I mean, there are some actors out there who they've made a name for themselves, and even if the movie sucks, you know, we'll love it because it's Will Smith or because it's Jason Statham, whatever, you know, I'm just naming, like, big names. So, drawing it back to this movie, the writing, I mean, there was no, for me, it was amazing, it was so great, and all of these actors bring something so special and unique and funny, and they have their own quirk, and they really embodied these roles so amazingly, so I was so in love and enamored with the cast. So, that's the cast, and I think everyone was so well casted too, it was so great. The writing was so great. I think the writing was, it was very strong, and had it not been strong writing, that's where the movie may have fallen a bit, because, you know, it's not like a big Hollywood blockbuster, it's not this big studio movie. Because the writing was so strong, that's where it excelled, and that's what was able to make this movie so great. I loved the movie, and now I'm just gonna rave about the fact that I loved the movie. It was hilarious. I'm not gonna lie, there are, and it's funny because I've been out of high school for 6 years, and I find in my personal life, and then what I see in this movie and a lot of other high school movies or teen shows, there's a bit of a disconnect, or there's, like, differences now, even if I'm still young, and there's not much of a, like, age difference, there's a lot of, because the high schoolers now are growing up in a different political climate and social climate, so there is a difference in the way that teenagers are now and the things that they care about more. And while I don't 100% relate to the way they were raised, or does that make sense? Like, I don't 100% relate to the issues that were going on, that are going on now. Like, I didn't go through that when I was that age. Even though I can't 100% relate and I'm not that age, I still loved the movie and I thought it was funny and it was still relatable. There are some scenes where I'm like, oh my god, it's the same. Like, oh my gosh, relatable. There's just funny. And I think that humor can go through, like, all, you know, ages. It doesn't matter. I saw a few older people, and I'll be honest, our theater was so empty. There's probably, like, 15 people. I'm being generous. In that movie theater, there's something about, like, in more independent movies, and it really sucks, and I totally understand that a lot of movie companies, you know, it's a risk because most people, the average consumer, will go see Fast and the Furious because that's a huge name, right? They'll go see a reboot of, they'll go see Aladdin because everybody knows Aladdin. It's hard when you have an original story, and those tend to not do so well in theaters, and it makes me sad because it discourages writers and filmmakers from creating original content. to say propaganda. Propaganda sounds so negative. But there's a lot more feminist content out there. As in, you know, we'll see a movie and then, like, Ghostbusters instead of, you know, the guys, it was the girls. And then, what, you know what I'm trying to say? Like, there's basically women empowered and empowering women, which is great. But there are a lot of occasions in which it's done in a very tacky or cringy way. And I'm all about empowering women and showing women in power. But there's a very great and honest way of doing that without being over the top and excessive in order to push a specific agenda the way that this movie did it. I mean, both of the girls, one of the girls a lesbian, the other is, I mean, they're both super feminists, and their icons are these, like, Susan B. Anthony and you know, strong women in power. But there was, they did it so amazingly, and that's a lot of the people that we see today, a lot of the youth, they're starting to see more, like, feminist, I hate the word agenda, too. It's just a lot more female, and we're starting to open our minds up to seeing women in positions of power and being empowered by women and being strong female characters. And the way that this movie did it, every single female character, whether or not they were super feminist or not, was a strong female character. And I think that that's more important to show rather than showcasing their beliefs, if that makes sense. They were very strong without necessarily being, you know, I don't know what's a good way of saying it, but I hope that that makes sense. The way these characters are written is so honest and real, and they felt like real people. And so I really loved the movie, and that's why I feel like